Hello and welcome to another seated Tango Stride movement session. Thank you for joining me today. It has been a very sad week for us and our Tango Stride family. So I wanted to start off by saying that and sharing with you all that we lost one of our Tango Stride students, Joe Francis, and we are pretty heartbroken about that. So I'm going to try to think of Joe today in our session, because they say that tango is an emotion that you dance, and so for all the emotions, the really happy emotions, the joyful times, but also the sad times. So I'll be thinking of Joe today and dedicating this session to him. So thank you for being here. As we get started, I want to remind you or let you know if you're new that these sessions are designed to be done seated, to be safe to do, even if you have balance challenges, so that you can stay seated the whole time and keep moving. And that's the whole idea for people with disabilities or who need support to stand. You can stay seated the whole time. Start with our balloon guy and just kind of let the music move you as if it was wind. The balloon guys are usually flopping around in the air in the wind, and then a gust of wind comes through and it fills them up. If you have a different mobility in one arm than the other, I encourage you to try to fill in the center first and then expand out. We can also expand forward and up. So maybe on this next one, think about filling in the center and then stretching up. If you need support for one arm, you can do this with one arm. Of course, you could stretch up with one arm. Another way you could do it would be to help your hand with the other. So that's a nice option too. Okay, breathe in. And then let's dance a little up here. Just kind of shift in your shoulders side to side. And then slowly lower your hands down. Come back to our balloon guy. I've also been thinking about all the people that are really affected by these fires that we've got going on the West Coast. And just hoping everybody's staying safe. And for anybody that's not directly close to the fire, I hope you're, able to breathe some clean air. Hopefully you have a place that, like, you can close the windows and the doors. Breathe in, let's stretch up one more time. Let's lower down slowly. All right, let's do a little twist side to side. You can hold hands, or you could open up. You can stretch arms out. actually it's kind of turned into a little bit of a, like a swing. And swing one arm forward, swing the other arm forward. And again, with your mobility level, adjust this to fit what you are able to do, what feels good in your body. And maybe you want to double it up or slow it way down. This twisting action is really important to keep our mobility, because a lot of our energy goes kind of forward and back and more even forward. So this twisting action is really good. Just touching your knee. So as you swing forward, touch your knee. Swing forward, touch your knee. And if you want, you can raise your knee. Or maybe it feels better to just kind of swing up and bring your knee up. And maybe for you, your knee lift is just a little like heel lift off the floor, and that's good too. But kind of using this upswing as a way to lift. Or a little tap. So I was actually thinking of Joe earlier and some of our other students, and the really cool thing about our Tango Stride program is that when we used to gather in person, and even now on Zoom, they'll inspire each other. I love seeing that in our students. So one person will do something and then they kind of, you know, sometimes it ripples through the whole group. So one year for St. Patrick's Day, one of our students, Sean, did a little jig where he was like crossing his feet and stuff, and then our student Joe, who we're remembering now, was doing his own little jig with his feet. So let's maybe, in honor of Joe, just kind of march your feet to one side, and then march your feet to the other side. You might feel a little stretch here. Let's keep going with this a little bit. So if you are having trouble lifting your feet, then you could think about scooting your feet sideways. You think about lifting just your toes or just your heels. You could kind of shift your heels to one side, shift your heels to the other side, or your toes. Kind of freestyle it out. Do a little dance. Do a little, your version of a little jig. Joe is kind of marching to one side, marching to the other side. I'm so amazed at all of our students who, you know, it's not easy for a lot of them. Getting up is a challenge. So Joe was definitely an inspiration for so many of us. All right, let's march our feet forward. If your shoulders kind of start getting into it, that's good. Go ahead and let them do that. And then march them back. Can you march behind you? Get your heels back there. If you've got space under your chair like I do, you can tuck your toes under and get a little stretch on the front part of your leg. If you don't have space to go under your chair, you could do it right here, like right underneath. A little stretch with your toes here. I'll take off one slipper so you can see. I'm just kind of tucking my toes underneath, because we oftentimes will stretch this way, but how often do we stretch the other way? Actually, let's do that. Let's march our toes out and see how if you can stretch your toes as long as you can. And then then march them back. And now can you go with your heels forward? And heels back. Toes. Heels. Let's go to our arms and our hands. Actually, thinking of Joe, he would interlace his fingers. So let's do that. Either interlace your fingers, or you can hold your hands like this, or you can hold one hand with the other. I'm going to go with interlacing my fingers. Whatever feels like it's an option for you. And let's try to think about pushing like the palms through. If you got your fingers interlaced, that'll work. If you're holding like this, then you can try to push your palms through, or just circle. We'll get to that, everybody, but let's go ahead and do this stretch through. Oh, another way to stretch your wrist this way would be with one hand, if the interlacing isn't working for you. Do this, or you could on your chair and then lean forward to get, because you want to get that angle in your wrist to your arm. Lean forward. And since we're doing this stretch, let's also stretch the other way. Now, if this isn't much of a stretch for you, you could do this also on your chair or with your hand, like this, and hold it. I'm just showing you different options. Or like this. Let's hold it for a little bit. And rock back and forth. I like to try and show you different options so you can find one that works for you. And maybe you'll tell me of some options you came up with. So that might be useful for other people too. Alright, and now holding hands either like this or like this. Let's do our roller coaster. I was just looking at pictures from when our student April and her husband Tony, who love the Puyallup Fair. Any of you that like the Puyallup Fair and that's your thing too, you've got company. They organized last year about this time. I think it was actually September 13th or so. We went as a little team to the Puyallup Fair. That was a lot of fun. Did we go on a roller? We went on the Ferris wheel. And that was actually Joe's idea. If you were interlacing your fingers, you could interlace the other way. And you can make your roller coaster really big. Nice way to kind of stretch those fingers and your wrists, especially if you're, you know, writing a lot or typing a lot or doing anything using your hands in one direction. It's good to kind of get stretched the other way. All right, let's let our hands go. For any of you who have a lot of tone in one side or both sides, one image that works for one of my students, Paul. Hey, Paul, if you're out there, shout out. Was this idea of like blooming hands. So if you squeeze your hands really tight and then open them up like they're blooming flowers. And then squeeze really tight and open them up like they're blooming flowers. This year with everything that's going on, I've had more time to pay attention to when things bloom. That's been a nice little kind of getting more in touch with the seasons. Another way you could do it is squeeze your fists and then release and think about stretching your arms long, your shoulders down. Or maybe another way to think about it is your fingers down, blooming down, your shoulders like back, but not up, but like opposite direction from your arms, if that makes sense, like to make your arms longer, but not pulling down like that. So shoulders up and back, maybe. Not like this. Speaking of shoulders, let's go to shoulders. Squeeze your shoulders and let them go. Ooh, gentle. I don't know if you guys are a little tight like me, but I feel a crunch when I drop them too fast. So gentle. Squeeze. And let's circle backward up to your ears. Let them go. You can kind of get your elbows in the action too. Keep your crown on. I noticed I was starting to dip down, crown on your head. All right, let's circle the other way. And adjust the speed at which you're moving. I always encourage you to go a little slower, especially if you're trying to figure out like how to coordinate everything, or if things feel maybe a little uncomfortable. If you go slowly, you can really feel if there's a spot where you need to stop, or you can make an adjustment in your movement. It'll feel better. All right, let's go one shoulder at a time now. One shoulder, and then the other shoulder. One shoulder, and the other shoulder. And you can bring your arms into it, like you're swimming. And let's go back the other way, like you're swimming backwards. And if this movement is not available to you, like reaching your arm up, you could think elbow back, and you can make it small. Doesn't have to be such a big kind of circle on one side. You can follow your hand or follow your elbow. Follow with your eyes. And I know we did the little twist with our back. This is our last time before we do a cool down, so I want to make sure we get our back going in all the different directions. So let's do a little stretch. You can think elbow up or just look down, but think about stretching one side and twisting your spine sideways. Or not twisting, bending, I guess, curving. And think about lengthening the ribs, like space between the ribs. Let's go the other way, so you can elbow up. Stretch, think about opening those ribs up. So for this next song, it'll be our last song, kind of cool down. Actually, let me see. I might switch it up here. It's a good one. Gris on this gray afternoon. Gray because of smoke. Really gray because it's been sad for us, for our little TangoStride family. But whatever you're feeling, we're going to dance this last song. Freestyle through your body, but we go through like different body parts. So let's start dancing with our back, because I feel like we still could have gotten some more movement, especially forward and back. But whichever way you feel inspired. And this is really great, especially if you spend a lot of time sitting. Get that movement in your back. Maybe do a little dance every once in a while. Put on your favorite song and have a little dance party. So we gotta keep moving. whatever you feel with the music and the body part we're focusing on, so elbows. And keep your crown up. I don't know why I keep wanting to look down at the floor. Keep that crown up for anybody that needs to hear it. Fingers. And if you're not able to pick up your hands, you can do this in your lap. Dancing with your fingers. Let's dance with our nose. Let's dance with our knees. About your heels. Thinking of Joe's jig. And your toes. For joining me today in this seated Tango Stride movement session. I hope that you're taking really good care of yourselves and each other. Thank you for remembering Joe with me, and we send our hugs and condolences and lots of love to his wife Lisa and his whole family. And hope everybody out there is able to stay safe with all the fires out there. So take really good care, please, because the better care we take care of ourselves, the better care we can take of the people around us. Let's do a big group hug to everybody who's watching with us today, and a little extra love to Joe and his family. And we'll see you next time. Same bat time, same bat channel.